Let us learn about the concepts related to 16th group elements. Again, what are the elements belongs to this group are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. So once again, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium. These elements included under sixth group because in all these elements the number of valency orbitals are 6. Hence it is called as 6th A group elements. They are also called as 6th A group elements. And the last, due to presence of last electron in p orbital, they belongs to p block category. Here oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium atoms of periodic table belongs to 6th group, 16th group or 6th A group family or 6th A group elements. Now these, sometimes the 6th group element, 16th group elements are also considered as chalcogens. Chalcogens. What is chalcogen means? Ore forming metals. Chalcogens means ore forming metals. Sorry, ore forming elements. Ore forming elements. The word chalcogens is derived from Greek word or Greek language because many metals are available in the form of their sulfides or oxides or remaining elements, the combination of remaining elements of same groups, and especially copper is available in its sulfide form or other complex material form in combination with selenium, tellurium, polonium, etc. So once again, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium and polonium are belongs to 16th group family or 16th group, and they are also called as chalcogens because they are ore forming elements. Why? Due to the variety of metals are available in the form of their oxides and sulfides. Now let us have occurrence of 16th group elements. Here the first element belongs to this group is oxygen. It is most widely available element in Earth's crust. Nearly 46.6% of oxygen by mass available in Earth are available in Earth's crust. In Earth's crust. And also dry air consists of nearly 20.946% of oxygen by volume. It is the most abundant element when compared to remaining all from the periodic table. Next, one more element belongs to same group is sulfur. Here the sulfur widely available, it is available in Earth's crust in the form of in the form of sulfates and sulfides. In the form of sulfates and sulfides. Let us have few examples for sulfates and sulfides from which we can isolate or we can get sulfur atom. Example for sulfates, they are barite, BaSO4, the sulfur available in its sulfate form. Next, Epsom salt. The molecular formula of Epsom salt is MgSO4.7H2O. Similarly, gypsum. It is nothing but CuSO4.2H2O. So all these are available in Earth's crust. So from these we can isolate sulfur atom. Here these are sulfate forms of sulfur, whereas the same sulfur is also available in sulfide forms. Example for sulfide forms, zinc blend having the molecular formula ZnS. Similarly, copper pyrites, which will have the molecular formula CuFeS2, copper pyrites. So one more, galena, PbS. So these are sulfurs, sulfate forms available in earth crust, whereas these are sulfide form of sulfur available in the same earth crust. Here these are the sources to produce sulfur element or sulfur atoms. Whereas one more, at volcanoes a trace amount of hydrogen sulfide, that means sulfur available in hydrogen sulfide form. It is a gaseous compound. So this is the availability of or occurrence of sulfur. The sulfur available in its sulfate form and sulfide form at earth crust, whereas a trace amount of sulfur present at volcanoes in the form of hydrogen sulfide. Similarly, some natural compounds like hair, some type of proteins, garlic, onion, mustard, wool. So these are some natural chemical substances or natural substances like hair, proteins, garlic, onion, mustard, wool. They are also consist of sulfur atoms in their chemical composition. Next one, the remaining elements of the same group are selenium, tellurium and polonium. Once again, the two aspects which can release oxygen are, once again, oxygen is the most abundant element when compared to the remaining all. Nearly 46.6% by mass of oxygen available in earth crust, whereas the dry air consists of 20.946% of oxygen by its volume. And next, sulfur available in its sulfate forms and sulfide forms. Example for sulfate forms are barite, Epsom salt, gypsum. These are the molecular formulas of respected salts. Whereas the sulfides are zinc blend, copper pyrites and galena. So these are the molecular forms of those ores. Whereas a little or trace amount of sulfur available in hydrogen sulfide form at volcanoes, and also some natural chemical substances like hair, proteins, garlic, onion, mustard and wool also consist of sulfur, and remaining like selenium and tellurium. Okay, selenium and tellurium atoms of same group available in their selenide and telluride form. Selenide and telluride, that means selenium and tellurium by reacting with metals, they are going to available in earth crust in their selenide form, metal selenides and metal tellurides form. Similarly, polonium is a radioactive element. It is released from decay of radioactive elements such as thorium and uranium. That means these two elements consist of radioactive character. So in their radioactive character, they decomposes to produce polonium. The polonium, released polonium, also having radioactivity character, and related to remaining elements of same group due to a radioactivity character, polonium is relatively having less lifespan. Nearly it is with 13.8 days of half life. So when compared to oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, so polonium will have less lifetime, nearly 13.8 days of half life. So this is what occurrence of 16th group elements, oxygen in earth crust and from dry air, sulfur available in their sulfate forms and sulfide forms, are also a little amount of sulfur in its hydrogen sulfide form at volcanoes, and hair, protein, garlic, onion, mustard, wool type of natural compounds are also consist of sulfur, where selenium, tellurium available in earth crust in their metal selenide and metal telluride form, whereas the polonium is a radioactive element. It is available from decay of thorium and uranium, and the less lifetime, that means polonium will have less lifetime, nearly 13.8 days of half life. This is what occurrence of 16th group elements.